How do we control robots? Well, to control anything, we need first a mathematical representation of it somehow. Let's see the general structure of robots and how we can model it. Stay tuned! Let's first analyze the main mechanical components of a robot, and let's consider for the moment a simple robot like a robot manipulator. The mechanism of a robot manipulator consists of two distinct subsystems, one or more in the factors and an articulated mechanical structure. An effector is any device intended to manipulate objects, a gripper or a hand for example, or to transform them like tools, drill, paint guns. The effector usually, written as, constitutes the interface with which the robot interacts with its environment. Then the rest of the robot is the articulated mechanical structure that places the end effector at a given location, position orientation, with the desired velocity and acceleration. And the mechanical structure is composed of a kinematic chain of rigid links. In the three extremity we have the end effector, while the other end is fixed and it's called base. The rigid links in the kinematic chain are connected by joints. The joints allow the robot to move around, and for this reason they represent the degrees of freedom of the robot. Usually for N plus 1 link we have N joints, hands and degrees of freedom. And we have two main categories of joints. The revolute joints that can rotate, articulations, no more people articulations are revolute joints. The elbow for example that rotates with respect to this axis, it's a revolute joint. What about the shoulder? It can rotate in every direction. Actually, with respect to three axes, this, like this, and like this. So these kind of joints that allow rotation in every direction, in fact, group together three joints and are called spherical joints. Then we have prismatic joints that instead can retract and extend. They're basically Mr. Fantastic, Inspector Gadget and Elastic Gear's articulations. Prismatic joints can be found mainly in industrial robots manipulators, but the other robots generally have only revolute joints. So, we just model a robot. That's simple, no? Right? The model we created looks like this. I don't know where I'm gonna put it. This. This is the base, the cubes are prismatic joints, this extends in this direction, this in this other direction, this in this other direction. The cylinders, they represent revolute joints, and the axis of the cylinder is the axis of rotation of the revolute joint. Among the different joints we have the links, and at the free extremity we have the end effector. And what if we have a human robot? The model is still the same, but in this case the robot is free to move around and we have no fixed space. Yes, this f***s up everything. Yeah, it's more complicated to control these robots, but nothing stops us guys, we still control them. The base of a human robot is referred to as floating base and is generally associated with the waist. We then have five end effectors that are all connected to the floating base, the head, the two hands and the two feet. The model of a human robot looks like this. We have only revolute joints, and if we have a look at the shoulders and the hips, we see that we have three orthogonal revolute joints really close to each other. This is because they emulate spherical joints. Well, that's it for today guys, and in the next video we'll see how we can practically specify the model in our code. Stay tuned!
I hope you guys liked it. If so, hit the like button, subscribe, ring that bell so to know when more videos like this are out. It helps us out so much. I'll see you there.